knows a lot about the science stuff. Professor Dave explains.
In the previous tutorial, we discussed the hagfish of class Myxini. Now let's check out the only other group of extant jawless fish, the lampreys. Lampreys are found in both freshwater and saltwater environments throughout the world, and they are important ecologically as both predators and prey. Though they are most infamously known for their parasitic feeding habits, in which they attach themselves to other fish using their circular mouth and sharp teeth and then feed on their bodily fluids, only about 18 lamprey species are parasitic or carnivorous. The other 20 or so known species are filter feeders that consume small particles of food from the water. They are all members of class Petromyzontida, or more accurately, order Petromyzontiformes. In order to examine these animals, let's check out their anatomy, life cycle, and classification. Lampreys have a long cylindrical body that lacks true scales and is instead covered in a thin layer of skin. They have a cartilaginous skeleton that is reinforced by some bony elements, including the skull and several arches that support the gills. Instead of true vertebrae, they have a series of cartilaginous structures called arcuolia arranged above the notochord. The mouth is surrounded by a sucker-like disc that is used to create a seal against the host fish in parasitic species, allowing the lamprey to feed. Their circular mouth is also equipped with a rasping tongue-like structure called the buccal funnel, which is used to rasp away flesh and create a wound on the host fish so that the lamprey can drain blood and other fluids. Meanwhile, non-carnivorous species use their teeth to scrape algae from rocks. Adult lampreys have large eyes, a single nostril atop their head, and 7 gill pores on each side of the head. Juvenile forms, however, look entirely different. In addition to their anatomy, lampreys are well known for their life history, which includes a radical shift in morphology and diet with respect to carnivorous species. All known species of lamprey swim against the current up freshwater rivers to breed. While freshwater lampreys, many of which are also non-parasitic, may live in the same stream their whole lives, marine lampreys are anadromous, meaning they leave the sea where they spend their adult lives and migrate up freshwater streams to spawn. In North America, lampreys spawn in the spring or early summer. Males arrive first and begin building a nest to later be joined by females. Mating is external, and males fertilize sticky eggs as they are released, which then adhere to the pebbles of the nest and become lightly covered in sand. Adults die shortly after spawning, and eggs hatch in about 2 weeks into tiny larvae known as amocetes, which closely resemble the cephalochordate Amphioxus. In fact, they look so different from their parents that when they were first discovered, they were thought to be an entirely different species. Like Amphioxus, the amocetes display all ancestral chordate characteristics and filter feed while wedged down in the sediment, much like cephalochordates. As they feed, they grow, and eventually, after reaching a size of about 1 centimeter, they leave the gravel nest and drift downstream to burrow into a sandy area where they continue to filter organic material and slowly grow for another 3 to 7 years or more, until they rapidly metamorphosize into adults. This change is dramatic and involves the formation of eyes, a buccal funnel and keratinized teeth, enlargement of fins, modification of the gill openings and digestive system, and the maturation of gonads. At this point, some non-parasitic species cease feeding entirely, while others continue to feed on algae. Some parasitic species may remain in the stream, while others migrate to the sea and attach themselves to the body of a fish with their sucker-like mouths and rasp through their flesh to consume body fluids. Some species remain at this stage for up to 3 years before they begin their migration back upstream to their birthing grounds. Phylogenetically, lampreys are considered the sister group to the hagfish, and those clades combined are considered to be the sister group to all other vertebrates, namely those of clade Gnathostomata, the jawed vertebrates. There are only 10 living lamprey genera, and their phylogeny was recently reworked in 2023. The pouched lampreys and southern top-eyed lampreys have long been considered basal to other species. Pouched lampreys are often locally abundant and reach sizes of about 60 centimeters as adults and are parasitic before becoming reproductive adults. Top-eyed lampreys are often much rarer but have a similar life history. Of the remaining species, perhaps the most well-known, in the northern hemisphere at least, is the 1-meter-long sea lamprey, also known as the vampire fish. It is infamous as an invasive species in the Great Lakes region, where it feeds upon trout, damaging local food webs and disrupting fishing industries. An individual lamprey has the potential of killing 40 pounds of fish through its 12 to 18 month feeding period. However, not all lampreys are parasitic carnivores that destroy fish stocks. Many, like the American brook lamprey, are harmless filter feeders for their entire lives, using their specialized oral hood to capture and filter food particles from the water. And that wraps up our introduction to the jawless fish. Let's continue by looking at the form and function of the cartilaginous fish of class Chondrichthyes.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.